size don't matter. It's about the skills when you get in there. Sometimes you could be smaller and beat up the bigger guy, and then sometimes you could be bigger and beat up the smaller guy. We learned that from Tommy Hearns. We learned that from Lennox Lewis. We learned that from different fighters. So hopefully we'll bring in a fight like this and bring y'all history, you know?
Canelo said everybody from 147 to 154 is bigger than him. Do you agree with that?
It's a lot of guys that's taller than me at 155.8, you know what I'm saying? It's okay, you know, he's still a stud, he's still a dog. You gotta go ahead and annihilate him.
Jermell, can you take anything away from Bebo's game plan? Or?
Right, I can, go ahead.
You know, I brought this fan for you. You know, just as...
About me a fan or you a fan?
I brought... You know, the fans wanted to say what's up. But now in this fight, just it's difficult when you're famous families and people excel. Now as a man, what does this fight mean to you just for your own legacy as an individual?
Well, it's great. It means a lot to me because I have a family, you know, and I have kids and I have older kids too, like... 12, 13, 14. I have 11 and 8, about to be 14. So, and a little baby. But it means a lot. You know, I got nephews, I got everybody watching. I think I have to put on a great show. I have to protect myself and hold it down for them. Because, you know, like it means a career defining moment. And I always prevail, if you know me. I prevail when it comes out of this time. This is when I jump out of there and it's like, wow, we didn't expect that out of him. So.
I like how you said that this is a fight you've been pursuing for many, 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 many years. When did you know this was the fight for you since you had that against him so early on?
Well, I think back in the days, I don't think Canelo would remember when he fought Alfonso Gomez. It was in Houston. He had a press conference in there. I was like, I want to fight this guy. Like, we should just go ahead and get it out the way and fight. But thank God it didn't happen now. Like, the fight is bigger, the money bigger, and it's a better moment.
Jermell, first of all, how are you feeling today?
What's up, Eddie?
That was a beautiful face-off. Afterwards, up on stage, Canelo told you something. What did he tell you? And you smiled.
Oh, he just said, we forgot our belts in New York. So, yeah, he mentioned that. We forgot our belts.
Now,
Canelo's a cool dude.
You have a Bruce Lee tattoo. Why?
I just like everything that Bruce Lee stands for. He was a fighter, to me, was a solid, I know, actor, but he was also a real, he taught, I think, some of the world of combat sports right now, some of the things that we, you know, motivated and learned from. Bruce Lee was really unique.
What do you take from the face off?
You're a top pound-for-pound fighter, right? Top five pound-for-pound fighter. So where would a win against Canelo place you on pound-for-pound list?
I think it'll put me in the top four. I gave up on learning, caring about the pound for pound. I see everybody got their pound for pound list, and there's no defying pound for pound list. Whoever decides to create a union and put a pound for pound list together, you're gonna have to be rich because you're gonna have to pay everybody that's on the list. And then that list gonna matter. That's when the box is gonna rock with y'all. When somebody's saying, okay, you know what? Whoever on the pound for pound list, we're gonna either give you a stipend every month or give you some bread every, I don't know. When it changes, everybody get paid. Some type of way it gotta happen like that, like, cause there's no union in this thing. And so, we won't be able to figure out what pound for pound list really matters. But you want to know a secret? I think that if you pay any boxer or anything, they're going to take it.
By the way, you always are ready. You don't get ready, you stay ready. Tell me about that. You've been ready for this fight 2 months ago.
Yeah, and that's a secret, Ellie. You know, I've been, I think I talked to you personally. I gave you 4-1 and told you something's big about to happen. I don't know if I even told you if it was this exact
you
moment,
did.
But don't tell nobody, Ellie.
Okay.
You're supposed to keep it cool, bro. Let everybody know what's up. But Ellie's, you know, he got my phone number. He be calling and stuff, writing us and stuff. But shout out to Ellie. He always in the media, dog. You know, y'all got to respect these people that come out and don't stop coming out. Dante Boston, they always been around. Then everybody else, they haters. Like, you know, I know a lot of people that say that, but I ain't here for that. I ain't here to bash everybody.
We'll switch to the topic. How about the two face-offs today? What did you see in his eyes? What do you think? What do you?
He know I'm ready. I think he knows I'm ready, and I know that he ready, and I know he gonna try to bring something different to the table. You know what I'm saying? I think he's gonna bring something different to the
can
table.
Can he bring something different?
We gotta move down, guys.
Canelo, can he bring
Ellie,
something
different? We'll see you at the gym.
Right, so,
now that you're at 168 pounds, man, we gotta start calling you. We gotta go back trying.
Right, am I?
We love to see
what's
you.
What's up, right?
I always represent.
Rick, how's it going?
Hey.
Okay, so talk to me really quick.
How she can't do the interviews with you. Come on, get on. Come on, get up here. You know how that place, Ellie.
How was the press conference?
It's good. We're ready.
It's been a great tour.
How do you feel different?
If the fight was tonight, he's ready.
100%.
I've been always a solid good guy. You know, I've been having to go down to make weight, so I know I can be 168 anytime. I know I can be a bigger if I wanted to. I made some adjustments, some changes, and I'm excited about that. So I can't wait to fight. 7 weeks away. 7.5 to 6.5.